While we've learned quite a bit about the mysteries of the past, there are still plenty out there to drive a researcher mad. From the numerous random intoxications at the Temple of Apollo, to the cave systems housing thousands of undiscovered species, here are 15 of the most mysterious places scientists still can't explain.
Everyday objects would be turned to stone.
Number 15. The Hellmouth, Badagaika Crater. There's a 300-foot deep crater in Siberia that's both terrifying and exciting to scientists around the globe. Expanding at a rate of 30 to 100 feet every year, the crater gives experts a fascinating insight into 200,000 years of climate history. Layers once inaccessible to research teams are now exposed in all of their glory. At such an expansion rate, scientists are excited at the notion of what it would expose next. The crater is referred to as a mega slump and dubbed by locals as the doorway to the underworld, hence the Hellmouth terminology. As permafrost continues to chew away its layers, the hole grows deeper and deeper, revealing more and more. This enables researchers to see details of the past like what the landscape looked like, the quality of air, and knowledge of the future natural erosions. This eroding hole of nature could very well be the key to surviving the changing climate. Now, let's get ready for today's open discussion. Considered one of the greatest lost wonders of the world, the Valley of Love in Ireland has inspired and allured artists of all types since it was revealed to the world. The photo you see before you is one of the many artistic renditions of the place and how it feels to explore. According to locals, the valley is older than the ancient pyramids of Egypt. Most have no idea this fabulous place still exists, despite being 3,000 years older than the pyramids. The fascinating structure you can find at the top of the valley is known as the Memorial of Joy. Though the exact reason for its construction is unknown, the incredible piece of art holds up remarkably well, even on the inside. Get this, the structure is so old and mysterious that humans have deemed the people who built it a mystery race. Who were these fascinating engineers and artists that could construct such marvels far before they had proper tools to do it, at least to our knowledge? You want to know a little secret? If you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you'll have superpowers for the rest of your life. So what are you waiting for? Time to fly. Number 14, the Temple of Apollo, Greece. With much of the modern science we have available today, it's easy to test and see where wild theories of our forebears got their mythological ideas. Thousands of years ago, the Greeks and Romans acted upon the future based on the Oracle's prophecies at Delphi, housed at the Temple of Apollo. Her predictions were honored and believed for an incredible 2,000 years, making the temple the center of religion for the same time. Recent research shows that 2,000 years of human decisions could have been based on the machinists of someone high on natural gas. Geological surveys of the site reveal that the temple ruins lie over a fault cross that emits intoxicating vapors. Yeah, you heard that right. 2,000 years of human history was guided by a woman high on the fumes of natural gas. If that isn't telling of the power of the human mind and belief, then I don't know what is. Thanks to the writings of Greek author Plutarch, who served as a high priest of the temple, we've clear records of how the oracle went about her business. The oracle was always a local woman, dubbed the Pythia once she became the oracle, who entered a trance inside a small chamber called the Aediton. These trances often deepened into delirium, even death, should she remain in the fumes for too long. Since the room was constantly filled with incense and other fragrances, it was hard to determine everything contributing to the delirium. Number 13. Pic de Bougarache, France. About 12 years ago, a rumor spread on the internet that a small French village, Bougarache, with a population of 200, would be the only place to withstand the impending apocalypse predicted by the Mayan calendar. Residents of the small village say they have no idea how their tiny little village became the center of the wild theory. Despite many news stories of people flocking to the village, less than 2 weeks before the assumed doomsday, not a soul took to the streets. Houses were shutter closed and market shelves empty. While the village certainly looks like it could be the last civilization on Earth, the theory fell through one of the many cracks present in the apocalyptic theory. When asked about the Mayan theory in their village, locals don't believe in the rumors. However, they believe the majestic mountain, in whose shadow the village rests, holds magical properties to keep the land fertile and ripe. A place like that during the end of the world would undoubtedly offer certain disadvantages over many of the cities around the globe. The connection between all residents, too, would help them keep the village afloat amid disaster. To be fair, that could be said of many low-population villages out there in the middle of nowhere as well. Number 12, the Ringing Rocks of Pennsylvania. There are stones in Pennsylvania that, when struck with a hammer, emit a gorgeous bell-like sound. In 1890, J.J. Watt would be known as the first to perform a rock concert. The joke, of course, is that he performed with literal rocks. Only about a third of the rocks sing, and the conditions have to be just right. In the 60s, a group of scientists smashed, broke, and sliced the rocks to learn more of their magical musical attributes. After performing numerous tests, they found that all the rocks do, in fact, ring. But some ring at such tones that the human ear can't hear it. The exact mechanism by which they ring, however, still remains elusive to the scientific community. They suspect it has something to do with the freezing and thawing process over many years. Number 11. The Lechuguilla Cave, New Mexico. In the 1950s, cavers realized that they could hear wind from underneath the Lechuguilla Cave floor. They concluded that beneath the rubble was a series of passages. It wouldn't be until 1984 that researchers would be granted access to explore such possibilities. 2 years later, they uncovered one of the world's most extensive tunnel systems, and they were large enough for humans to walk through with ease. A total of 120 miles of passages have since been discovered, and explorers have pushed the cave's depths to 1,604 feet. These astounding facts make this tunnel system the deepest limestone cave in the country, the fifth longest cave in the world, and the third longest in the United States. A crazy discovery. The unexplored passages and mystery attract cavers from all over the world. Even its entrance is majestically adorned with large amounts of gypsum and lemon-yellow sulfur deposits. Other discoveries include the chemolitho-autotrophic bacteria, believed to feed on sulfur, iron, and extremophile, microbes that experts suspect will yield remarkable medical properties once harnessed. The problem is removing the bacteria from the cave. It doesn't survive long after leaving its unique ecosystem. Who knows what new mystery might emerge from this insane cave system? Number 10. Tunisia's Mysterious Lake. We can all fall prey to the monotony of our everyday commute. It's easy to miss things that have been there all along when the path is well traveled. Now, imagine being in that mindset and a lake just appears along your route one day. How many double takes would you have to do before confirming your suspicions? I think the addition of a massive lake would draw my attention, no matter how far in peripheral view it may be. Water is hard to miss, with its glistening surface and moving body. Lac de Gafsa, as it's now called, appeared as if out of thin air. For years, there was no lake, and then one day, it just showed up. I wish I was making this up, but this report comes from the people that travel these roads every day. Many commuters said they had to pull over just to make sure they weren't hallucinating. News of the mysterious lake spread like wildfire, and soon the lake was chock full of tourists. A few months later, it would become one of the world's most populated tourist areas. Experts had been studying a prolonged drought in the area just days before the lake's emergence, making the sudden appearance of the lake all the more curious. Number 9. The Mobile Cave, Romania. If you're afraid of the dark, beware of this topic. Okay, maybe it's not as extreme as lions, tigers, and bears, but I'll let you be the judge of that. Far in the southeast reaches of Romania, near the Black Sea and the Bulgarian border, lies a barren, featureless plain. The desolate field is unremarkable at first glance. Still, with a closer look, it will reveal a world teeming with life of unprecedented quantity. Just below the barren rock is a cave that's managed to remain isolated from the outside world, including air and light, for an incredible 5.5 million years. While our ancestors were learning how to make fire and evolving into modern humans, the inhabitants of this underground city thrived. Researchers are astounded at the possibility of life down there. Despite the complete absence of light and a poisonous atmosphere dense enough to kill a human in just a few seconds, the cave is sprawling with life. Such a hostile environment proves life always finds a way. Researchers suspect there to be in the upwards of hundreds of undiscovered species, including spiders, scorpions, lice, centipedes, and the completely undiscovered. Though it still remains untouched, experts are furiously trying to get inside without disturbing the ecosystem and staying alive all the while. Number 8. Rock of Al Nasla, Saudi Arabia. I know what you might be thinking after first glance. Someone laser cut that rock. I assure you, the cut is as natural as the stone itself. That doesn't mean it's any less remarkable. In fact, it's probably even more so. Experts are baffled at this mathematically precise cut, not to mention the perfect balance each half displays on a small foot. The formation has existed since ancient times and has taken centuries to acquire its unique shape. This rock is only one of many rocks that features a unique appearance. The limestone, shale, and sandstone located there are some of the oldest on the planet, having undergone the most prolonged period of erosion and weather stripping we know of. Though experts are unsure of how the laser-precise cut came to be, it is possible that water once ran through a crevice, slowly etching away the stone until eventually it made its way all the way through. It would also explain the small slates of rock that hold these massive stones balanced. Only time will tell, unfortunately. It could be a more extended period that you, or I, or our children will ever see. Nevertheless, time is the deciding factor. Number 7. Wrangel Island, Russia. The Wrangel Island Reserve is a self-contained island ecosystem. Evidence that it's undergone a long evolutionary process uninterrupted by glaciation is evident. The number and type of endemic plant species, the diversity of those plants, and a plethora of mammoth tusks and skulls are evidence of Wrangel's rich natural history and unique evolutionary progress compared to the rest of the Arctic. The island is still untouched and is being heavily observed by satellite and drone imagery. Even the creatures that call the island home behave differently than the rest of the same species spread out over other islands. There's truly something spectacular going on here, and researchers have no idea how or why. The island is home to the world's largest population of Pacific walrus and the highest density of ancestral polar bear dens. The island is a researcher's dream. Who knows what untold secrets lie in the untouched depths of Wrangel Island? Number 6. Superstition Mountains. If you've ever been to the Grand Canyon, then the Superstition Mountains are right up there when it comes to beauty, and in fact, it's the second most photographed and artistically reimagined landmark in Arizona. Next time you find yourself out toward the Grand Canyon, make sure you head to these majestic mountains too. If you're not asking what's the superstition, then you haven't been paying attention. There are multiple facets and legends to give rise to its name, but all of it's been subject to years of change and lore. To that end, the factual answer is no one knows. The truth is locked away in some grave or the very mountains themselves. According to the head of one of the many museums that dot the mountain landscapes, the mountain was called many different names by a handful of different cultures over the many years in which it's been populated. To say one name is more official than the other is just lunacy. The Crooked Top Mountain, Thunder Mountain, Mountain of Foam, all names for the mountains over the many years of civilizations that dwelled there. In the 1860s, people started disappearing on a mythical hunt for a mountain of gold, gaining its modern name of Superstition Mountains. Number 5. The Chocolate Hills, the Philippines. Nope, these aren't giant cocoa mountains. That'd be awesome. The famed hills are typically covered in green grass, but during the dry season, it shrivels up and turns the landscape into a chocolatey brown powder for as far as the eye can see. The color alone isn't what makes these mountains spectacular. There are more than 1,000 hills spread over an area of 50 square kilometers. Now that is something to see. You can observe the magical landscape from many of the surrounding towns. The gorgeous hills vary in size, but they give a stunning, symmetrical aesthetic potent enough to satisfy the perfectionist of any intensity from a distance. The sight is so visceral in its symmetry that they're often mistaken for man-made creations. Only when you encroach the hills do you get a sense of their varied sizes and enormous scale. Number 4. Mother Shipton's Well, England. When humans have a hard time comprehending something, our minds often wander to solutions like magic, devilry, or witchcraft. History is a testament to that. According to legend, Mother Shipton's cave houses a well that can turn into stone. I know, it sounds like something straight out of mythology, right? Could it be real? Turns out there indeed is something strange going on in the cave, but it sure as heck isn't witchcraft as it was once believed. Science has typically come to the rescue to explain the natural phenomenon at work. The story states that Mother Shipton was a witch and an oracle who predicted doomsday horrors and disasters that were to befall the Tudor reign. With each morbid forecast recited in poetic prose, her most famous prediction says, "The world to an end shall come in 1881. Like most other predictors or prophets who foresaw the apocalypse, they were wrong. It's important to note the context of her words during the time in which she said them. England would have been the world. The well in her alleged dwelling petrifies some objects that enter and has been attracting tourists since 1630. It's one of the oldest places of tourism in England. The water can turn objects, such as teddy bears, hats, and other fabrics, into stone with a period of a few months. The natural process of evaporation and unusually high mineral content residing within the water are to blame. It certainly can petrify things, but not in the instantaneous way the legends would lead us to believe. Number 3. Lake Natron's Petrifying Lake. Another petrifying body of water, only this time on a large scale, Lake Natron may appear like a typical lake nuzzled between rolling hills and mountainous terrain. Still, there's a nasty secret hidden within those dangerous waters. Lake Natron is often likened to the type of place where the evil genus or enemy lives, the Mount Doom of reality, if you will. Like the mystical Mother Shipton's Well, the lake has a massively dense salt concentration that, when evaporated in combination with the many minerals present, turns the wildlife resting nearby to stone. Today, the lake is home to a variety of ghastly, calcified animals forever frozen in time. It makes the lake appear as some sort of animal graveyard and thus an eerie aura. From calcified flamingos and bats to fish and turtles, few animals resist its potent concoction. A more in-depth natural process goes into Lake Natron's heavy density of salt and minerals. Lake Natron is a salt lake, which means water flows in but can't flow out. The only way for it to rid itself of excess water is through the process of evaporation. Earning its name, the lake is also massively dense with the chemical natron. Throughout the year, the lake's pH level can reach a whopping 10.5. That's right up there with ammonia. One fish species has been discovered with the ability to withstand the harsh waters. Named the Alcalapia latilabris, this bizarre fish thrives on the plethora of algae growing in the lake. With no natural predators to hunt them down, they thrive. Number 2. Coral Castle, Florida. Neither coral nor castle, the famed Coral Castle of Florida is a collection of more than 1,000 tons of the oolite limestone that was quarried and sculpted into various shapes, including a water fountain and a sundial. The work of art and engineering has been likened to Stonehenge and the pyramids of ancient Egypt. That is an incredible comparison. That means they expect this site to live on through thousands of years to touch another generation of human beings. The park features a perfectly balanced stone gate that, despite its incredible weight, would easily swing open with a strong breeze or a gentle push. Eventually, the door stopped swinging, revealing a vast complex mechanism fashioned from a truck bearing and a metal rod. Number 1. Darvaza Crater. It's really no wonder why this crater has been dubbed the Gates of Hell. I really can't imagine the Hole of Fire being called anything else. The Darvaza Crater is a 9-meter wide and 30-meter deep crater near Darvaza Village in the Karakum Desert, Turkmenistan. Flames have been spewing from that crater for years. When you consider how large the crater is, those flames spewing are massive. This is unfortunate, an accident humans caused. Soviet researchers set up a sizable digging rig in the crater to find raw pockets of natural gas. They found them all right, but a lack of caution ignited them before having a chance to harness it. The Earth had other plans, and the shifting sands swallowed the platform whole, leaving its methane veins exposed and heavily leaking into the atmosphere. With no way of sealing the thousands of threads spewing methane, scientists did what anyone does when they don't know what else to do: burn it. The crater, which is still spewing flames to this day, will be burning until its massive supplies end. Such a shame to literally watch all that natural, usable gas burn to waste. The fires will eventually cease. Even with all the technology we have today, secrets of new and old still evade explanation. How was it built? Who built it? Why? All questions that plague the human mind and pervade human history through legend, lore, and story. While scientists can't explain it today, who knows what yesterday might bring? If you enjoyed the video, smash that like button, and don't forget to subscribe to get all our content delivered right to your inbox.